Hello, I'm Maha at Maha's Musings, where today I'm going to be doing a book review of Fredrik Backman's story, A Man Called Uva. Now, this is a book where the main character's outward appearance belies his inner significance. And by that, I mean, don't judge a book by its cover or a person by their outward persona, always. So who's Uva? He's a 59-year-old crotchety man in Sweden, and he's just perpetually angry at the world. He's the kind of man who points at people he doesn't like the look of as if they were burglars, and his fingers a policeman's torch. One could be forgiven for thinking that, you know, someone like Uva is quite racist, but he's anything but racist. He's just someone who's very lonely, and he's been trying to take his life for a while. He's been attempting it for a while, but he keeps getting interrupted by his neighbors who keep coming to his door. So he has no peace, and he just wants to have a bit of peace and time to himself and just get away from the world. I really appreciate how Backman has written a very sort of thought-provoking story, and where he encourages us to look at people a little differently than we tend to do because of our, you know, inner bias in front of our eyes and minds. So what are the pros to this story? Well, there are a number of pros to this story, which I really appreciate. Certain relevant themes to the story, for example, love, loneliness, loss, the process of aging, doing the right thing. I also appreciate how he talks about migration, the process of migration, which can add to a community, which can enrich a community and bring something to it. I also appreciate how Backman uses humor in certain poignant situations, you know, and he allows us to even laugh at certain things that don't really seem funny even, you know. And that is why a cat, an overweight allergy sufferer, a bent person, and a man called Uva make the inspection round that morning. So just after you've read something really solemn, comes this sort of visually funny scene in your mind, and you laugh out loud, and it's the perfect tension relief, you know. I like how Backman talks about his early years, about Uva's early years, his upbringing, and his relationships in his childhood, his early work on the railroad, his failures, and then when he meets Sonia, his wife. He was a man of black and white, and she was color, all the color he had. So just by reading that line, you understand how much he loved her. And she loved him as well. I also appreciate how the role of age plays a significant part or is addressed in this story. Now, this is not something that I sort of really noticed when I read this book the first and second time. It's only this time that I read it, I realized how age is a significant theme within this story. And it's something that is inevitable in everyone's life, you know, whether you are a single widower like Uwe, or you are, you know, a couple like the neighbor next door, Anita and Ruin. It affects us in different ways. And he talks about the men in white or the bureaucracy that comes and takes over your life, you know, and it also addresses issues of dignity and even humiliation. And this is something which Uwe was not able to do in the earlier part when it came to his wife, but then he channels that anger and energy he has to right the wrongs of the past. Uva and Ruin were from a different generation in which one was what one did and not what one talked about. So although Uva is a man of few words, he's a doer. His actions always speak louder than words. And that is why he's able to rally people of different temperaments, age groups, inclinations around him. because he has something within him that they see, and that thing is called decency and kindness and doing the right thing. And so underneath his persona, underneath his quirky persona, he's got a very kind heart, which just comes to the surface in a way that is, you know, like sandpaper. Piranha looks slightly embarrassed. Sorry, Uva, don't worry about what they've written. You know how children are. My father died in Iran. They've never had a, you know. Uva took no notice of her, just takes the drawings in his hands. They can call me what they like. No need for you to stick your bloody nose in. The drawing with two granddad gets the top spot on the fridge. So, you know, this man with this, non-PC attitude has got a real heart of gold. And, you know, my throat sort of like constricts when I read this, and I'm not even reading it aloud when I'm reading the book to myself. And this is the third time I'm reading this book. And it just brings out those same emotions to me the third time around. So it really says something to me, Backman's writing. And my favorite part of the book was the relationship or the bond which Uva had with Cat Annoyance, or the cat he adopted. You know, initially they're measuring each other out, you know, like two boxers in a ring, you know. And it turns out that this cat is someone who replaces the companionship which Sonia gave him. You know, in a way, I felt as if this cat filled that loneliness, that lonely spot within him, you know, within his heart and mind. And I felt as if this cat was like a reincarnation of Sonia, as if she'd sent this cat down, or she was a reincarnation herself. Something in its eyes reminds him of the way Sonia used to look at him. Uva doesn't need to know what she would have thought. The silent approach has always been her preferred trick when there are disputes with them, whether she's alive or dead. You can just sense how strong their bond was, you know, that non-verbal communication between them. So what are the cons to this book? Well, there are no cons as such. You know, this is a really heartwarming read. There are parts in this book that were a little dry, you know, and you just wanted to move along. You're like, oh, okay, it's getting a little dry here. And then there were like the chapter titles, which were like a little too long. But these were just minor glitches, you know. Overall, this is a very heartwarming read, and with very significant themes. I know a lot of people have read this book already on social media, but those who haven't, do read it for yourself. I kind of preferred this to his non-fiction read. I think he does fiction better. That's just my humble opinion. I'd give this book a 4 stars, a solid 4 stars. And thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any feedback or any comments, I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to read them. I always do. It's very encouraging. And if you have any suggestions regarding my booktube and what you'd like me to be doing, what books to be reviewing, or what I could be doing books related, do let me know. So thank you so much for joining me today. I'm also on Instagram, where I write my book reviews. And I'm also on Goodreads as well. And do subscribe to my channel, Maha's Musings, if you haven't already. Thank you once again, and have a good weekend. Bye for now.